When we ask our attorneys about the type of disclaimer to present at the beginning of a video that specifically outlines how to permanently delete a project, they said the most important, the most critical thing to mention. In this video, we'll cover duplicating or copying a project. We'll cover transferring, if you want to transfer a project to someone else, if you want to transfer it to a team, or even if you want to transfer it to yourself, which is, believe it or not, an actual thing. And we'll talk about deleting a project. Let's talk about making a copy or duplicating a project. First thing, we want to go up to our project settings. Once we're there, we can go and duplicate the project. Now, you can choose exactly which settings you want to copy, and when you continue, the duplicated project will be moved to your personal dashboard. That means, of course, if you're part of a team account, check your personal dashboard for the duplicated project, because that's where it went. That's duplicating. Now, let's talk transferring or moving a project. Again, you can do this from the project settings. Now, all you have to do is transfer the project, but there's an important note. When you transfer a project, like we're demonstrating here, we're transferring to Gremer, it completely moves that project from the original location, in this case, our account. It moves the project, it completely transfers it to whatever location you select, Gremer's account. You can't undo and you can't get it back. In other words, if you're transferring your project to somebody and you don't want to permanently lose it, don't transfer it yet. Duplicate first. Duplicate your project, then transfer that project you duplicated. That way, you have a copy on your side of things. Now, you can also transfer a project to a team. If you're part of a team, you can just select that option when you go to transfer the project. Okay, what do we do if we need to transfer a project that has hosting? What if it has a custom domain and it's set up for hosting? Well, we can remove the hosting, then transfer the project to whomever we want to transfer the project, then have them set up the hosting. Or if we want to keep the hosting where it is, we can duplicate and transfer like we did a few moments ago. That's fine. In that case, hosting will still be attached to the first project, and the one that was duplicated and transferred can be set up however you want to set it up. But there is another way. If our goal is to set up hosting for a client, if we're talking freelancing or agency work, if we created a project for a client, we can just use client billing. Client billing means the project stays in your dashboard, but you can set your client up to automatically get billed for fees related to service. You can calculate profit, add tax information. We have tons of information on client billing on Webflow University, so check that out if you haven't done so already. Now, last part, deleting a project. From any project, from the project settings, you're looking for delete. To permanently delete your project forever, that's the permanent part, type what you're prompted to type in the field below. Also, you can copy and paste it. But that's deleting a project, and that's it. We talked about duplicating a project to make a copy, we talked about transferring a project, we talked about deleting a project forever, and now Dylan's going to abruptly cut to a black screen before